When we all went into lockdown back in March of 2020, an MIT scientist started to study exactly how the coronavirus pandemic began. And she decided a lab accident in Wuhan, China was one plausible explanation.
That subject, if you recall, triggered a political firestorm. Over the past 20 months, Alina Chan has grown a huge following on Twitter, attacked by one camp and called a hero by another. Well, she's written a new book, and I went to Cambridge to talk with her about what she calls her exhausting journey.
And this all began just because I wanted to ask the question, could this have come from nature or from a lab? And somehow just raising the lab hypothesis offended a whole bunch of people and powerful people. But behind the scenes, in private, actually have received a great deal of support from other scientists.
In fact, after being dismissed as a conspiracy theory at the start of the pandemic, those questions about the possibility of a lab leak have even started to seep into popular culture.
How did this happen? And they're like, a pangolin kissed a turtle.
But Alina Chan warns this is no laughing matter. A researcher in gene therapy at the Broad Institute of MIT and Harvard, but not a virologist, she co-authored the book Viral and argues that searching for the origin of COVID-19 is vital to preventing future pandemics.
If we don't say anything, this will happen again and again and again.
The book makes the case for both possibilities: natural transfer of the virus from bats to mammals to humans, or some sort of lab accident at the Wuhan Institute of Virology that spread to the community.
We make the strongest argument possible for each origin, and we let the readers decide. So we don't know the answer.
And some people believe that you have pushed this theory that it leaked from a lab by accident.
Yeah.
But that there's really no evidence for that right now, is there?
So there's no evidence whatsoever for a natural origin or a lab origin. So all of the existing evidence is circumstantial.
So no, there is no hard evidence yet. But as another leading infectious disease expert told CBS News, everything is on the table.
The lab leak hypotheses are absolutely legitimate. They are plausible.
Despite personal and professional attacks online questioning her qualifications, she insists she won't be deterred.
I actually do have a very strong background in handling viruses and engineering them.
Does it make you sorry that you started all this?
I don't regret pushing so hard because the scientific community really needed to step up and rebuild public trust.
So the book catches everyone up on what's happened so far. I read it last week. You know, it's all been so confusing since then. But she does point out, David, that whatever you think, no safety changes have been made in either the wildlife trade or lab safety. So we are in the exact same spot right now that we were 2 years ago right now.
And everything is so secretive, you wonder if we'll ever really know the truth.
She thinks we will, that there's so much information out there in the world. She thinks eventually either a whistleblower will come forward, or just so much information does exist. When someone feels safe enough, they will come forward.
All right, good interview, interesting story. Okay.